Yay, it's Sue Greenwald here with Awakened Stories, and I'm here with John F. Kennedy Jr., the real and original one. Hey, John, how are you?
I am doing awesome, Sue. Like I
Awesome.
keep saying, every time I get to spend time with you and chat, it makes my whole day. It really, really does.
We normally talk every week, except I think we skipped a week or so, but it's all good. And a lot of times I tell people in my travels about you know, that I'm talking with you on video, and they all light up and then they get confused. And then I tell them about what we do. And then I say, we kind of shit talk the government. Every one of them loves that. They love it. So it's so exciting, isn't it? So,
It breaks my heart. I can't stop thinking about all the people that are asleep. There's so many people that are. I know the truth. I know what's really going on because I'm the son of an assassinated president and had to live that lifestyle of, in hiding and trying to stay alive, my whole life. And people aren't awake. They got the cabal, two sides. They got the Democratic Party, the Republican Party, and they're waving their flags for these people, and they are the cabal. These people waving the flags have no idea what's in these people's closet. They are run by the shadow government, and it really is saddening. I'm in Arizona. I see Trump flags, Trump bumper stickers everywhere I go. It's Trump, Trump, Trump everywhere. And it's like the man is a thief. The man is a criminal. And, there's so much, he needs to be in prison. There's so much I know about the man stealing millions of dollars from me. He is organized crime at the highest level. He's been president of the United States. And I'm trying to expose what a scumbag he is, how he was my cousin, my loved one, and he was murdered. He was replaced by organized crime so they could keep all these billions of dollars in their little circle. And it's heartbreaking because I know the truth. And the program they want us to stay in with the media that's been taken over and everything else that's been taken over, that people are just, I don't want to call them stupid because they're not stupid. I've been stupid myself, but they're unaware of the brainwashing, the programming. And the, when we're little, we're taught everything we know. And these people are taught to wave their flag for a man named Donald Trump. And they need to really hear what I'm saying and wake up and see that he was best friends with Epstein, see that he did, ran pageants, that he had little girls sitting on his lap, and what they really do, the child trafficking and every other thing, it's so huge. I'm a victim of our government's corruption. I was thrown in a dog cage. I was screwed in the butt. I was so abused as a kid, so I wouldn't talk. Well, I'm talking now, even if it hurts my feelings. Like I said, I was screwed in the butt, but I was actually tortured many, many times not to get this out. I'm getting it out, people, so I hope you listen to me.
Right. So you went from being a child, 3-year-old child, taken care of by nannies, surrounded by Secret Service, jet setting everywhere, living the life most of us can't even imagine, to basically being tortured, kidnapped, every bad thing you can think of. And
Yeah, I mean,
because of
talking sitting down with a gun at my head to made to eat rat poison. I was I when I was young, I was jet setting all over the place. But then when I grew older, I was jet setting around the world to try to stay alive from the cabal. They didn't want me sharing the story.
Right.
The John, the whole world knew. This comment was made the other day. Well, he was just a child. He didn't know any better. Organized crime placed him in as a child to take your identity. Well, that's one thing, but when he became an adult, he knew better. When he wanted to have me killed so I would never expose what's really going on, he wanted me dead. They were taking me to that wedding to kill me, to end my life. So, with that said, yeah, he didn't need to try to kill me to keep living a life of luxury.
Right. And it sounds like he has probably murdered many people because in that one photo that's in your book. So here's John's book, Stolen Identity, available Amazon, Barnes and Noble. And easy to read, hard to hear these stories, but it has to come out so we understand how things are operating, how things have been operating for a long time. But anyways, basically it sounds like, you know, in that picture in your book where you're comparing rings, you're in school. Let's see. You said he got that ring for murdering someone. And he was only like,
and it was probably one of my loved ones.
Yeah. And he was only
it was the takeover, and they used children from a young age.
Yeah.
I'm a personal eyewitness. What they did. It's you know, the John Gottis of the world.
Yeah.
And all these people, they don't have a problem committing murder, using identity theft to steal their money. The media will say organized crime doesn't exist anymore because they're the media. They're organized crime.
True.
You know, Donald Trump will say, yeah, the media is organized crime. They're all corrupt, but he's part of the same crew. He's just calling his buddies corrupt. They're still putting him on every single day.
Right.
It's all the same circle of crime. Right.
So we've talked in the past months, you know, everything was based on this book. So our videos were based on this book, but John has through the months shown us how and why organized crime takes over someone's identity. And basically they usually replace that person and they have that person's power, authority, finances, wealth, money, whatever it is, business. So that's a really easy way for them to take over and control the assets, which are usually sucked out and funneled off to someone else. Right.
Oh, they put funds in other people's names.
Yeah.
And then they get those people to pay up.
Yeah.
The billionaires don't tell you what they do. They'll get a boy and turn him into a girl and then put all this money into their bank account. And you're looking for a little boy's bank account when it's a little girl. I mean, the crazy things they do to hide their money. And you got to remember, they're the cabal. You either do what they say, or, you know, we only have one life, and they use that one life against these people. You either pay up or die.
Right.
It's that simple.
And we know, those of us that are watching already see in politics or any influencer, entertainer, whatever, they're super attractive, famous women that are really men and vice versa. And we're seeing that more and more. A lot of times I'll talk about this with somebody, I'll say, oh, that's a dude. And people will be like, no, it is. It happens way more than we understand or realize. Those people are totally controlled and they have to do what they're told or else.
And it's from a young age. They start off from a young age. They really do.
Yeah. So one thing I noticed is we have a picture. I'm going to see if I can put this picture from your book. Look at the guys in the background, the kids in the background. You see what they're doing? Nazi salute.
Yeah, and I remember that day very, very well because the teacher was actually educating us on Hitler.
Oh. And, you know, kids do stupid things, right? You know, but it just seemed appropriate knowing who some of those kids were.
Well, it's like even John in that picture sticking his tongue out.
Yeah. So, okay. I wanted to talk about a couple things before we get down the rabbit hole a little bit. The first is you have a new website out that went out a few days ago. All right. So I'm going to put the link in the description, but the website is The Real John F. Kennedy Jr. Okay. It's a long one.
And it is awesome, people.
It's awesome. Really is. So it kind of gives an overview of the timeline, of course, not of every highlight of your life, but kind of a lot of the salient points of your life. It talks about, you know, it shows video highlights. It's beautifully done. So for those that want to go see more and want to learn more about this story, obviously we're recommending the book because that's more comprehensive. The website's very well done. So that's the first thing I want.
Yeah. To and thank you, Sue.
Thank you.
And thanks, Kimberly.
Yeah.
You guys are awesome. I can't do that kind of stuff. I don't have time to do that. And you guys stepped in and said, let's do it. And I hope God blesses you.
She
guys
did 99%. I'm just the
hey, it's all yeah, good, yeah. But she's awesome.
The other thing I want
to know, right at the front of the website, you got my book. Yeah. They don't want you people to know what's in this book.
Sure.
And this book, every time somebody buys a copy, gives me a couple dollars to make my life better. They have left me in poverty. I was sharing with Sue right before we started. I get letters. I get love offerings and gifts from people. Sometimes I don't get back to you a lot of times because I am so busy. I'm remodeling my son's house to make it livable for me and Robin, so we have a place to stay. But your love gifts and offerings are so helpful. I got a letter in the mail the other day, and it looked like it had been run over by the Postal Service forklifts over and over and over again. And in that letter, it was from a gal. Did you get my card earlier? It had a kitty and a puppy on it. But anyway, this one letter took 3 weeks for me to get. I remember I did get a letter a few months ago with a puppy and a kitty on it. So thank you so much. I don't like to tell people, you know, names or anything on who sent me things. But I was sharing with Sue. We're trying to remodel a house with nothing and get the paint and everything, buying discount and thrift stores and all this. And somebody sent me a gift of a few hundred dollars yesterday, and I was able to go to Home Depot. So you know who you are, and you're so very much appreciated. And I hope God blesses you like crazy for just trying to help me get out of poverty. And thank you all so much. And you know, that comes back to these necklaces. The king, he donated thousands of dollars with these necklaces so I can have a better life. He said, John, sell these and make your life better. And so far, so good. It's been awesome with a great response. These are going to go down in history, people. They really are. It says, unveiling the real John Kennedy Jr. on the back. It has Smarties logo, source directives. And it's an awesome pendant. And it helps get this story out any way we can. It really does. Right. And it's going to be a collector's item. Right now, there's 100 of each. There's 100 of the gold, 100 silver, 100 of the rose gold, 100 of the black, and the rainbow. And they come in the small and the large size. Right. So whatever you prefer. My favorite is this silver one right here. And they got King's logo and are filled with frequencies.
Right.
And I love mine. It helps me with my post-traumatic stress disorder. When I start getting stressed out and worried about getting a bullet in the head, I grab this and hold on to it, and it brings me back to reality. It really does.
Right.
And sometimes my reality is really harsh to handle. It really is. If you don't know my story, I've lost all the loved ones, not all of them, because I love a lot of people, but my mother, my sister, my father, my uncles, and my cousins, and my mother's side of the family. And just recently, I lost my son. So my losses are huge, but my story is worth it to get it out. You know, there's many people that have lost their lives trying to defend and protect this country, many. And why I'm doing this is because I don't want that all to go in vain when we lose control, which we are right now very close to losing everything in America.
Right, right. So basically, I've tried to show, and I'm not really very good at this, but I'm trying to show the front and the back of the pendant. There's small and there's large.
Isn't that beautiful? That's so beautiful.
It is beautiful.
It looks like liquid metal to me, the way it shines and glistens.
Yeah. And it has the picture that's on the cover of the book, which I think is a fabulous picture. But best of all, these are infused with healing frequencies. So for the past, I don't know, 5 or 6 months, whatever it's been, we've seen you looking a little bit rougher and then every week look better, 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 better. And so what has been the difference? You've been wearing your PTSD dog tag pendant that Smarty had sent you. Oops, you had a different one than this, but they have healing and protective frequencies. Now, in your gun, you have some of his products as well, which helps amp up the vibration in the house. So that has been the biggest difference. And you've been telling us stories through the months of how you've gone to the doctor and they're like, wow, I'm seeing such a dramatic improvement in your health. A lot. So recently,
Everything. Well, my health was so bad last year. Well, actually, it's been 2 years since my total heart failure, but I've had so many medical conditions hit me at once. I thought I was dying. I felt like I was dying. I made a video on TikTok and you could see that it looked like I was dying. That video probably had, I know it had a half a million views before they took it down. But every time I turn around, they wanted to put a pacemaker in me. They wanted to put the defibrillator in me. When I first had heart failure, I was wearing a big old bra and contraption with wires all over it. And that thing was beeping all the time. But they wanted to do that. And I went in, the doctor said, go in for a test first, one of my other doctors. I went in for my test and they said, your heart went up from 30% to 50%. So you don't need that anymore. The heart doctor said, whatever you're doing, keep doing it. And I was like, okay. Well, my doctor sent me to a cancer doctor because my blood count was all screwed up. This was a year ago. And yesterday, or day before yesterday, I should say, I went in to, I took a blood test last week, but I went in for the results. And the cancer doctor was like, how you feeling? I'm like, I'm okay. He's like, well, in the past year, everything's been good and getting better. So I don't want to see you anymore. There's no need for you to be here at all. And I was like, I don't want to be here. So yeah, the cancer doctor was like, go away. And I'm glad to go away. I'm so glad to go away.
So things are improving, and sometimes they're subtle. Now, some of the people in Smarties groups have had very dramatic healing and changes in their lives. It's been incredible. For many people, though, it's more subtle, and it takes, like, you'll notice improvement over time. So there's lots of factors that go into it, but it's beautiful to see how these products work. And so again, we're talking about them because we're excited, okay? You don't need to buy one, but if you do, it is a collector's item, but it will help heal you.
A quick story too. That one pendant that I had that was blue that King Smarty sent me. There was a gal and she said, I really want the blue one that King Smarty talked about. And I was like, well, we haven't produced them yet. King hasn't made them yet. And she said, but I really want one. She sent me an order for one. I think it was a rainbow one. And I sent her the blue one that I wore around my neck. I said, you want a blue one? You got a blue one now. But awesome.
Cool.
So
Very cool.
yeah, I hope the blue one she's got does what she needs it to do.
So the money that is collected from the books and the necklaces goes for living expenses, okay? And John often buys more books to gift people, right? And other things like that. So it's not like he's becoming wealthy, okay? But it helps. One necklace, one book at a time, it all helps.
Yeah, I'm definitely not wealthy, but it's a blessing, whatever. Me and Robin are living in a trailer. We're trying to rebuild a trailer now and make it nice enough to live in. So we have a bigger trailer. So it's not like John Kennedy Jr. has lived a life of what's been stolen from him in no way, shape, or form. Your blessings really, really help. I was talking with Sue. I said, hey, Sue. Yesterday, I had a couple dollars and I needed to buy some lumber to frame some windows and do some things in the house so we could paint and get it going. And I only had a couple dollars and I checked the mail and somebody sent me a blessing. So I went to Home Depot and it's not like I went to Home Depot and just started throwing lumber on my cart. I went to the coal cart. And if you don't know what coal lumber is, it's all crooked and bent and warped and broken, but it's 70% off. So I filled up the lumber with the coal wood that I could use. And I went to the checkout and, you know, I got 70% off what instead of buying it off the shelf.
Right.
So it's not like I got money to throw away and just start loading 2x4s on my cart at $5 a piece when I can get them at 70% off.
Right. Good move. All right. So, anyways, you lived this life of luxury as a child, and gradually, after your father was assassinated, that life of luxury trickled away. Like you were flown around, you did this, you did that, but eventually you ended up at the Quigley's where things went south rapidly, right?
Yeah, a lot of not, a lot of not so good,
Yeah,
really.
yeah.
The government, these people I'm trying to expose that run the Democratic Party, that run the Republican Party, they're not nice. They're all about their family, the cabal family, the satanic organization, the world they live in, and money and power. And keeping that power, they have no problem taking children's lives away from them, replacing children. They thought, well, you know, I'll never forget the words that they can enslave me and keep me as a slave. And even our federal agencies, they'll, you know, the flat out, they told me they're going to use me till the day I die for who I am. They do that. But I don't even know where I was going. I get all these bad thoughts in my head and everything else.
Well, let me ask a question. It's been 60 years now since your dad was assassinated. 60 years, all this stuff has happened, and you're like living independently, we'll say. Okay. You're living unaccosted at this moment. All right. So why do you think they don't want the story out now so badly? Because a lot of the guys that perpetrated these crimes are most likely dead.
But
Like,
so many of them are still alive.
so many alive. So I know you have names
You
and
know,
faces.
you got Donald Trump. You got
Yeah.
Bobby Kennedy. You got my sister, Caroline. These identities have been stolen. These members are hardcore cabal. You got Hillary Clinton, Bill Clinton. You got the Bushes. I've got so many crimes that I personally know about on all these people. Barack Obama. You know, these people are the heads of the top. And I could point my finger and say, you did this and you did that. You know, what about Waco? What about 9/11? And I know, you know, I'm a whistleblower. Excuse me. I think about that all the time. I'm the biggest whistleblower of the century. I'm John Kennedy Jr., for God's sakes. And my father was the president. And I got so much dirt, I'm blowing my whistle. The only problem is that little ball ain't in my whistle.
Well, we're trying to help
I'm
you
just going.
amplify. We're amplifying what you're doing by sharing this story around, telling people about it. So every time I go out, a lot of times people will like I wear Smarty Charms and the jewelry. They'll compliment the jewelry. That leads into a conversation. I tell them about you and the videos, and they're either like they usually go like excited, and then they're like, what? They don't know the story, the real story. I give them a little tidbit, I give them my card, and hopefully they're curious enough to research a little more, to watch these videos, to read the
They
book.
do so much to hinder us.
Yeah.
I got a team of lions and they get kicked off TikTok, Facebook, YouTube. Dr. Kia Pruitt's a good example. But Henry came to me, he got kicked off TikTok again. I think that's the fifth time he's been kicked off.
Yeah.
And he said, brother, the other day he messaged me, he said, brother, I got kicked off again. But when I put it, the info in and a phone number came back, it was a Washington, D.C. phone number. He's like, isn't that kind of odd that the hackers are coming from Washington, D.C.? Not really. They don't want this truth out.
Right. So we did a video. I'm going to say it was 2 weeks. You, I, and King Smarty, we were on a live video. It was really a fabulous video that was taken right down. And then, on YouTube, you have a little button you can dispute the them removing the video. So of course, I press the button, and they come right back with, "Oh, sorry, you violated our, community guidelines or whatever BS that was."
Yeah, I reposted that
Specifically,
same
how?
video and they took mine down too, Sue.
Yeah.
That, you know, they don't want this truth out.
It's true.
And you know, they're all run by these billionaires. They want us, you know, if anything major ever happened and it was the government against the people, they try to suppress the people. So we have, you know, we need to go old school. Everybody needs to get a two-way radio in their house if they want to communicate, because they're controlling every ounce of communication, all the way to the media, where they filter it out to us on what they want us to know, not what we need to know. And they've accomplished that. We're proof that they have. My story is the biggest story of the century. What they did to me, they can't prove me wrong. They don't want to prove me right, because, you know, but it's huge. It should be on every media channel around the world, and it's not, because they control it. They control it all. And we're in grave danger. And I'm screaming, we're in grave danger, people. The cabal are running things. They're putting these candidates in place so they can keep running things, keep destroying our country. You know, when I was at Home Depot, I was looking at lumber, the simple little lumber, $1 a foot to $2.50 a foot for the cheap stuff. I remember, you know, what was it, 30 years ago, you could build out your own house for $4 a foot. Now you can't even buy the trim to go around it for $4 a foot.
It's everything has gone up on purpose. Okay, so groceries, gas, utilities, apartments, you know, rentals, mortgage rate, like name something that hasn't gone up that we need.
And it's so sad, because you get people like billionaire Donald Trump, and people are sending him millions and millions of dollars. It's crazy. These people are so brainwashed.
So that's why I was saying, you know, we're getting like annoyed. People are annoyed because you're trying to promote the Pendant, right? When Donald Trump, a billionaire who has everything, you know, he has everything, is getting millions of dollars donated to him. All right.
Yeah, and
So
he's selling freaking sneakers, for God's sakes. I go to the flea markets and it's all Donald Trump merchandise. And we want to try to make life for all Americans by selling, you know, selling a little pendant, and people talk shit. It's really sad. And I want everybody that's listening right now, you all see Donald Trump going like this everywhere now. It's the biggest photo op this world has ever seen. Scene that was staged, people. It was just like a Hollywood reenactment. It was staged. People lost their lives, because that's what the cabal do. In a million years, that would have never ever happened. The Secret Service would have thrown him on the ground and drug him off stage, where a second shooter would not been able to take a shot. Ever happen. It's rigged, it's faked, and you all are brainwashed if you can't see it.
Totally rigged and faked. I mean, everyone in the audience that day pointed out that there was a guy up on the roof. Nothing was done. People were taking donut breaks or whatever. And of course, that poor guy is no longer with us, so we never will hear that true story from him. So
But yeah,
poor.
with that said, if you all remember my salute as a kid on my father's funeral day, when that casket went by, I did a salute. I want you all to remember, I was trained for hours and hours before I did that salute. It was a photo op, people. So when you see Donald Trump go like this, just remember, they were trained for hours and hours before that ever happened, and people lost their lives because they don't care. But if you're sharing that picture, get some intel, because that would have never happened unless it was staged, ever.
Interesting times, you know, like we're going to look back on this in a few years and say, wow, I can't believe we made it through that because it's been hard. I mean, I don't know. I mean, you've had a much harder time getting this story out, but people are feeling beat up, worn down. And I was telling John before we got started, like it's like we're climbing this up, you know, the steep mountain. We're not to the top yet, but we're really close. So hang in there. Don't lose your faith. Don't give up. Never give up. We're almost to the top where we can rest, and then it's going to be easy. Okay.
And there's
We
only one way,
got
I
the
can't
mountain.
sugarcoat it. There's only one way to fix what we got going on, and that's to eliminate the government and their power. There's only one way, and that's for us to share my story, use me as an example. You know, you can use many stories as an example, but use me as a story of my life story, what they've done to me.
Right.
And the more people we can get to say, hey, I don't want criminals running this country. I don't want the future of my children to rely on these murderers, these crime ring people in control of my children's lives. It's that simple. We unite, we can fix things, and we can get rid of the criminals in our government. Right. And I don't see any other way to do it than unite. I can't. So hit that share button, people.
Yeah. All right. Well, we decided to keep this video short today for multiple reasons, but we wanted to talk about the new website. We're very excited about that independence. And so anything you can do to support John is welcome. In the description, I'll put how you can send him a check so he doesn't have to pay any fees for the pendants, that kind of stuff. But your support is most appreciated. And we're not just doing fundraising here, although we have recently, you know, because we're excited about this, but this allows us to all help John while helping ourselves with the frequencies. So yay. Yeah.
And it's helping everybody. You know, I came up with that saying, justice for John 24 is justice for all. It really is. Yeah. It's just for everybody what I'm doing.
Yeah. Well, what we've talked about in the past, too, is this story is not just for the U.S. This is a global story, because what they did to one person, they've done it across the board to many. Now, those stories haven't come out yet. But you are
England, Ireland, Australia, it's global. It really is global what they're doing.
So you're paving the way for other whistleblowers. And for more.
Yeah, training. And we need our little ball in that whistle so we can make some noise. And they took our little balls away. They really did. Yeah. I need to learn to whistle, you know, without a whistle. But please share, people. Let's get the truth out to the world.
Yeah. So we're going to keep this short today, but we'll be back next week with maybe more content. And, you know, John's been working on his house and he's physically tired, I think, from all the manual labor.
Yeah, I've been going 24 hours a day, I think. It's crazy.
Yeah.
With that said, www.therealjohnfkennedyjr.com. Check it out. I'm going to repost this on YouTube. But if you have anything you want on the website, comparison of the ears, something, you know, anything that you want on there that you have a picture of, me as a little child, age progression, whatever it is, send it to me, and we'll try to get it on the website. But it's information on this website. There's my interviews with Sue, Kia. There's the interview with Guy. My movie Hollywood career is on there.
Right.
Everything they've stolen from me is on there. So if you want to get educated, go to www.therealjohnfkennedyjr and check it all out, people, and you'll wake up. I know you will.
Yeah. And I did watch some of those old movie clips that you were in, and I couldn't watch them all, but like some of them you were in right at the beginning, and it was so apparent that it was you, right? Like there's no question in my mind, right?
Because you look at that one picture where me and John are side by side, and then you look at the movie clips, and you look at this ugly mug right here. Look at my big fat earlobes. And you know, there's so many distractions, so many people trying to break us down, so many people trying to hinder us and say we're all full of shit, but check it out for yourself, make up your own mind,
right?
And you'll wake up to see what's really going on.
We can never give up, everybody. Gotta hang in there. And John, thank you for your strength and courage in getting the story out.
Thank you, Sue, so very much. Thank all your family and your friends and Smarties crew and everybody. You all are freaking awesome. Straight up.